everybody, and welcome to Believing Everywhere. My name is Michael, and I am the pastor here at Believing Church, and it is an honor for you to join us today online as we do something new, something we're calling Believing Everywhere. In this unique time in our world, we believe that the greatest way to share the love of Jesus is right here online. And so it's my honor that you would join us right now. You know, this season is opening up a lot of different and unique and creative ways for us to serve, for us to minister as a church. But it's also opening up creative and unique opportunities for people to serve as the church. I heard a story this week about a teacher in our church who, as we all know, right now isn't able to do what it is they love to do, what it is they do day in and day out so well, and that's serve kids, educate kids right here in our city. Well, she took it upon herself to just simply offer her services to her friends near her, saying, hey, if you need help tutoring your kid, knowing what to do, because as parents, we all feel overwhelmed with now the responsibility of trying to educate our kids, and am I smarter than a fifth grader or not? Probably not. So what do I do? We all feel that. And she just extended and said, hey, I'm here to help. I'm here to serve. And I was so inspired by that, because I believe all of us have opportunities in our neighborhoods, opportunities maybe at work, opportunities that we may walk right by typically. But right now in this season, they're an opportunity to serve. Maybe it's for a neighbor who can't go to the grocery store and you could go to the grocery store for them. Maybe it's to serve someone near you who their work is actually pulling them away from their house, away from their family all the more in this season. Maybe that's an opportunity for you to serve. I don't know what it looks like, but I believe the Holy Spirit will speak to you, and I believe your eyes are going to be open to find ways to not just say, I connected to a church, I gathered with a church, but I am going to go be the church. You know, our service is going to begin here in just a moment, and I want to encourage you to do one simple thing right now. Would you invite as many people as you can right now? You can take this link and share it on Facebook. Come on, you can text somebody, you can call somebody, shoot an email. Don't send a letter, it won't get there in time. But would you do everything you can in the next couple minutes to spread the word and invite people? Because service is gonna start in 2 minutes.
everybody, and welcome to Believing Everywhere. My name is Leon, and I want to thank you for gathering as a church today online. As a church, we want you to know God, find community, and make a difference. Everything we do is connected to these purposes so that all people are transformed in Christ. If you're new to Believing, welcome. We're so honored that you're joining in. We hope that you have an incredible experience and sense the presence of God in these moments that we get to spend together. Today, we're continuing a series called Goal from Golgotha, where we're discovering the love poured out at the final words from Jesus while hanging on the cross. In just a few moments, Michael's going to be bringing us a sermon based on some of these words, but that connects us to our situation today. Now, we believe it's going to be a powerful message. Plus, we're going to have a time of prayer together and be inspired by a song from some of the musicians right here at Believing. Right now, I want to invite you to do one thing, participate. Now, whether you're joining us from your phone, computer, watching us on TV, or whatever, let's lean in. For the next few moments, allow the Holy Spirit to speak to you, to encourage you, to give you the strength you need for today. You can utilize the chat to say hi to a friend or ask a question, receive a prayer, or say amen, whatever works for you. And again, we're just honored that you're here. Right now, I want to invite you to worship with us as a team leads us in a time of singing together.
Hallelujah. Heaven comes to fight for me. Yes, I am a child of God.
Aren't you grateful that we have no reason to fear? No reason to be afraid today, because we are loved and we are all children of God. I know I am. Again, we want to thank you so much for being here today. If you're new to believing, we'd be so honored if you take a moment to fill out the connection card. Just simply click that button now and fill it out. It'll give us a chance to say thank you for joining us today. And additionally, if you're joining us right now and you have a need specifically that you'd like for us to pray for you about, hey, we would love our team praying for you and your need this week. You can click that prayer button to let us know how to pray, or even request for someone to reach out to you and pray with you over the phone. We believe it is so important to get the truth of God and His Word on the inside of us, particularly in this season of social distancing. That's why Michael is writing articles every single day designed to build your faith and encourage you in this season. All of these are available on our website at believingchurch.com, or you can follow us on Facebook, as we're sending out a notification there every day when the article is live. As people of faith, we must trust God with our finances. We put Him first in any and every season. It's a demonstration of faith and a reminder to ourselves that God is our provider and our ultimate source. Right now, you can give online through the button above, or you can discover other ways to give on our website. Let's be determined to be the people who will not be controlled by our fears, but always live by faith. Right now, we're going to go into the third part of our Goal from Golgotha series and prepare our perspectives for this moment that Michael will be sharing with us. We want to show you a short clip from the movie The Passion of the Christ that depicts so clearly the love poured out from the place of the skull.
You know, difficulty really is a revelation. That's what it is. It's a revealer to you, it's a revealer to me of what we really value and what we really hold to and what really is significant to us. Anytime we face difficulty in our lives, whether that's personally, like in our own bodies, whether that's collectively, maybe in our family, in our close friends, difficulty in our work, or quite honestly, even difficulty that we're wrestling with as a country, as a community, as a world in this COVID-19 and the coronavirus pandemic that has literally changed the world for us in the last 7 days. That difficulty, because any difficulty, is a revelation. It's a revealer to you, it's a revealer to me of what's really true about us. It's a revealer to you, it's a revealer to me of what really does matter to us, what really comes out of us, because whenever difficulty comes, it squeezes us, it pushes us, it causes us to reflect and evaluate, it causes us to be exposed as to what's really going on the inside of us. You know, today we are in the third part of a series that we are doing called Gold from Golgotha, where what we've been doing as a church is exploring the words of Jesus that he offered while he was hanging on the cross. And even today, I believe that one of the most significant things we can do is lean into his words in that moment. And I want to tell you why. Because there was never a more difficult moment for Jesus than those moments, those hours that he was hanging on a cross, dying for your sin and for mine, for the sin of humanity of all time. There was never a more difficult moment. So if Jesus was bluffing, if Jesus was a show, if Jesus was a facade, if there was any moment where that could be revealed, that would be revealed, it would be that moment there. Those moments when he is literally being falsely accused, tried, convicted, beaten, a crown of thorns placed on his head, his body whipped to shreds, and then hung on a cross as a spectacle for everyone to see, for everyone to mock at. Those were difficult moments for Jesus. And if there was ever a moment where his true character would be shown to be disconnected from what he said when he was preaching, what he said when he was teaching, what he said when he was healing people, it would have been those moments there. Those difficult moments would be the revelation of who Jesus really was. And that's why I'm so encouraged, I'm so inspired as we study these words from Jesus while hanging on a cross. Because what you find is what came out of him in those moments was not anger, was not bitterness, was not frustration for what he had to go through. As painful and as difficult as it was, what came out of him was grace. What came out of him was love. What came out of him was unbelievable compassion for people that he came to serve. You know, today we're going to continue reading a few of his words, two statements in particular that Jesus offered while hanging on a cross. And I want you to turn your attention for a moment to John 19. These verses are going to be on the screen here for us. And I want you to listen to words that Jesus offered while undergoing more pain than any of us could ever imagine, while undergoing the greatest moment of trauma in his life. This is what came out of him in John 19. It says, when Jesus saw his mother standing there beside the disciple that he loved, he said to her, "Dear woman, here is your son." And he said to this disciple, "Here is your mother." And from then on, this disciple took her into his home. Jesus knew that his mission was now finished. And to fulfill scripture, he said, "I am thirsty." Now let's be honest for a second. Of all the statements that Jesus made while hanging on a cross, and there are seven of them, we've already explored two together. If you miss those or would like to learn more about those, they're on our YouTube channel. You can watch those there. But of the seven statements, these two are the strangest, aren't they? I mean, if you think about just drop the mic moments, so to speak, Jesus, the first one that we covered, he said, "Father, forgive them, because they don't know what they're doing." What a powerful statement. That's a drop the mic kind of situation, is it not? Because of just the boldness of this. There are statements like we'll cover here next Sunday, the statement that he offered where he said, "It is finished." What a powerful statement. I mean, that one you can put on the wall. That one you can tweet to somebody. It's powerful. But these statements, hey, mom, that's now your son. And friend of mine, he gonna need to be your mom now. And by the way, I'm thirsty. Those don't seem to carry the same weight, the same panache that the others do. Or do they? Or are these statements maybe just as powerful, just as significant, especially when it comes to revealing the character, revealing the heart, revealing the love of Jesus in this most difficult moment? I believe, especially for you and for me in this time, this moment that we live in, there are no more significant words that we could draw our attention to today than these from Jesus. Jesus says this. He says, "Woman, I want you to look. Here is your son." And he says to his friend, "Here is your mother." While Jesus was hanging on a cross, experiencing unimaginable pain, he had the wherewithal. He had the compassion on the inside of him to not just focus on how his body hurt, to not just focus on the blood pouring out of every fiber of his being, but to be concerned about other people. How incredible is that? Jesus had every reason in that moment to focus on himself, to focus on his own pain, to focus on his own situation, but he didn't. Jesus took it upon himself in that moment to say, "I'm going to turn my attention to other people." Why? Because that's who he was. Jesus, the compassionate one. Jesus, the loving one. Jesus, the forgiving one. That was just not something that he was in good times. That is who he was even in the worst of times. While hanging on a cross, Jesus took note of the fact that his own mother was suffering too. See, most historians, scholars that really study this and know, believe that Joseph, Jesus' earthly father, had died by this time. Mary was a widow, which is one of the reasons that you find her around Jesus a whole lot in his traveling, preaching, and teaching. But at the same time, too, Jesus would have been the one to care for his mother. And now he's about to be gone. He understands that his time is coming to an end momentarily. And rather than just focus on his own pain, rather than just focus on his own needs, he looks at his mother and has compassion on her because he understands even though he is dealing with pain, she is dealing with pain too. And he did not allow, I don't want you to miss this, Jesus did not allow his pain to blind him from other people's pain. If there's any encouragement I could give you today, and I know you're hurting, if there's any encouragement I could give you today, and I know that you're stressed, if there's any encouragement I could give you today, any challenge I could put before you, it would be this. Don't allow your pain to blind you from others' pain. Every one of us are hurting. Every person listening to me right now, I know you're scared. Some of you, it breaks my heart. Some of you, you lost your job this week. Some of you, you don't know how much longer, you don't know how many more times that direct deposit's gonna go through. I understand. Some of you have family members who are sick. Some of you are first responders, you're medical professionals, and you are literally sacrificing your safety. You are sacrificing your ability to be connected with your family because of other people. And my goodness, that hurts. My goodness, it has to fill you with fear, fill you with pain. I understand. People are worried about the stock market. People are worried about all that's going on. And all of us are worried because all of this affects us personally. Could I encourage you in something? Especially those of you watching right now that you have a faith in God, those of you leaning in right now, you're a part of this church. Jesus has changed your life. Don't allow your pain to blind you from other people's pain. Because yes, you are hurting, but so are others. Yes, your household is hurting, but so is your neighbor's household. Yes, you are filled with fear, but so is your coworker. And there is no greater opportunity For those of us who have a faith in what Jesus has done, those of us who have been changed by his mercy and grace, there is no greater opportunity that we have than right now than to focus on the pain of others, to not be blinded by what it is that's coming at us, but to open our eyes and see the needs that other people's have. Why? Because it is normal for us to focus on our own pain, but let me tell you, it is Jesus to focus on the pain of others. It's normal to be concerned about what's going on with you. It is Jesus to say, I'm gonna look beyond myself, even in this most difficult moment, even in this most challenging, unstable season, I'm gonna look beyond myself and be someone who is like Jesus. I'm gonna love because Jesus loved. I'm gonna serve because Jesus served. I'm gonna be generous because Jesus was always generous. I'm not gonna go blind to other people's needs. I'm gonna keep my eyes open to the needs of others. Because there are needs all around us. All around us. Maybe there's an opportunity for you to serve someone in your neighborhood. Maybe there's an opportunity for you to just simply smile and encourage somebody. Maybe there's the opportunity for you to pick up the phone and call someone that you think probably hadn't received a call in a while just to check on them. Can I tell you, you can either be overcome by what it is that's happening to us, what it is that's going on around us, or you can choose to not allow the pain that you feel to blind you from the pain of others. That's what I love about Jesus in this moment. He said, woman, that's your son. And you, son, that's now your mother. He took it upon himself to look at the needs, the pain of someone else and to care for it. And then he offers this second statement. Jesus says, I thirst. Kind of a logical but also peculiar statement, is it not? Logical because if you've been through what Jesus had been through, you would think naturally he would thirst, but that is not why he mentioned it. He actually stated this to fulfill prophetically what was said about him. In the Psalms, this statement is made that the Messiah would actually speak like this. And Jesus did this to fulfill what is prophetically spoken about him. But I don't want you to miss in trying to see prophetically what's going on here, what practically is happening too. Because Jesus, even in this moment of great pain, even in this moment of unbelievable discomfort, took it upon himself to be concerned about the will of God. See, what's so powerful to me is that Jesus was concerned about the purposes of his Father, even in his most difficult moments. He didn't allow his desires to keep him from his Father's desires. And if I could give a second encouragement to us today, it would be this. Don't allow your desires to blind you from God's desires. Even in this difficult moment, even in this difficult season, don't allow your desires to blind you from God's desires. Because if I get consumed with everything that matters to me, and everything that matters to me only, it's very easy to have my eyes cloudy and blind to the fact that God has purposes even in this season. I can say that with all the conviction in the world. That even in this season that's difficult to you and difficult to me, even in things that we don't understand what is going on, God has purpose even in this season. Even in the confusion, even in the chaos, even in the pandemic, even in the unrest that grips so many of us, God has purpose. But if we're not careful, our attention will go only to our purpose in this season and forget that God has something he wants to do right here, right now. What if you ask this? What if you stop right now to ask, to pray, and say, God, what do you want from me in this moment? What if that was your prayer right now? To say, God, what do you want from me in this moment? God, I'm confused, but what do you want from me? God, I'm scared, but what do you want to do through me in this moment? Because friend, God has purpose even in this moment. But if we allow our fear to blind us, if we allow our pain to blind us, we won't see his purpose in this season. Do not allow the difficulty that is on you right now to blind you from other people's pain and to blind you from the purposes that God has, even in this moment. Can I tell you, that's why I'm so moved by these statements from Jesus? Because he, even in unimaginable and unbelievable pain, chose to look and see the pain of the people around him. He chose to keep his perspective in check, to keep it where it should be, and remember that God had purposes, his Father had purpose in that moment. And I believe that this isn't just something that we lean back to and remember, but it's an example for us, that even in this difficult moment, we will look to Jesus as our Savior, but we'll also look to him as our example. Because he is our example here. And he shows us how to live, how to deal with unbearable pain, how to live, how to deal in unbearable times. And it's this: you care more. How do you get through the most difficult seasons of your life? You care more. How do you keep going when it seems like everyone else is stopping? You decide you're going to care more. You care more about the purposes of God than your own issues. You care more about the issues that other people have than your own issues. You choose to live beyond yourself. You choose to live beyond your own concerns, but to get focused on the people that are around you. Can I tell you, even in this moment when we have to be distanced socially, even in this moment where many people have to work from home or many people have to figure out different ways of operating life from day to day, I believe that this moment, now more than ever, is a moment for people to be like Jesus, to be like our Savior and our example, who wasn't just concerned with himself, but was concerned with others. And I believe there are people that live near you, people that you know, people that you'll talk to on the phone, people that you can reach out to that need you to be Jesus to them, to love, to care, to show concern, to give empathy, to actually care about what's going on with them and not just be consumed with what's going on with you. Because that could change everything for them. In fact, maybe that is what will change everything for you. You know, for the next couple moments, I want to ask you to lean in and stay with us. The band is going to lead us again. They're going to sing another song that helps us, even just for a moment, to set our eyes, our attention, our focus on Jesus, on our great God, and all that he has done for us. But I want you to stay with me, because here in just a moment, I want to give you an opportunity to respond and also take advantage of the opportunity that we have to pray together, even in this moment. So let's listen, let's worship, but let's come back together and pray in just a moment.
I cast my mind to Calvary, where Jesus bled and died for me. I see his wounds, blazing sun shall pierce the night, and I will rise among the saints, my gaze transfixed on Jesus'
though we carry a big weight right now. We carry a big weight because of everything going on around us. And what I would love the honor, the opportunity of doing right now is praying for all of us. Because I know we all got needs. Some of us have needs financially. Some of us have needs in our physical body. Some of us, it's just the fear. Every time we open up Twitter, every time we turn on the TV, it's just more and more and more, and we're overwhelmed. Can I tell you what you can do right now is what the scripture says. You can take all your cares, all your burdens, and give them to God, and He'll take them. So can we do that together right now? Would you maybe even where you are, sitting in the living room, at the house, if you're in your car, man, keep one hand on the wheel, but maybe you can do this with the other hand. Would you just simply lift your hands to heaven, this posture, just showing that you're releasing those burdens, you're releasing those worries, those cares, and giving them to God even in this moment, and let's pray together. Jesus, you see every one of us. You know every one of us. And I pray right now, every worry, every fear, every doubt you would take right now, that you would bring provision to people, that you would bring encouragement to people, that you would bring health to people. Jesus, we trust in you because you're bigger than any disease, bigger than any fear, bigger than any pandemic. And so in this moment, our faith is in you like it's never been before. You know, together, this is what we're doing. We are giving praise and giving honor to our God. And so often we can think that simply lives in a space where people sing songs, but no, in these moments, the greatest way to give praise to God, the greatest way to remember the love that was poured out from the cross is to demonstrate it to other people. It's to care for others. It's to realize I have and they have a need, so I'm gonna help. It's to continue to be generous. It's to continue to share. It's to continue to love. One of my favorite scriptures is found in the book of Hebrews, and it's a reminder to those people. And it says, do not forget to do good and share with others, because with such sacrifices, our God is pleased. And I believe even on a day like today, where millions of people around the world are not able to gather as the church in buildings, not able to gather in the way they normally would, we today get to gather online, but we also get to be the church to our friends, to our neighbors, to people around us. Can I tell you something? If you have a faith in Jesus, right now we need you. We need you to be like Jesus, to look at your neighbor and say, is there any way I can help you? Because they'll look at you strange, being like, everything good with them, and everything doesn't have to be good with you, for you to lift your eyes and focus on the needs of others. Some of you may be watching me right now, though. You may be tuning in. Maybe somebody shared this with you. Maybe you come to the church some, but you're like, dude, this sounds neat, but I don't understand how right now you can say what you're saying and actually believe it. And I'll tell you why. It's because Jesus has changed my life. My hope is not in the economy. My hope is not in my health or my strength or my uprightness. My hope is not in everything being good for me. My hope is in what Jesus has done. These words that Jesus offered that we took a few moments today to lean into, he offered while hanging on a cross. He was dying for the sin of all humanity for all time. That includes me, and that includes you too. And if you're listening to this and you're like, man, I want hope like that. I want to be able to look beyond my pain. I want to be able to look beyond my own purposes to a purpose that's greater than mine. Can I tell you, that can only happen when you trust in what Jesus has done for you. And so right now from where you're at, I want to lead you in a prayer. And all you have to do is pray this. The scripture says in the book of Romans, the Apostle Paul says it this way, that if you confess with your mouth that Jesus is Lord, and you believe in your heart that God raised Jesus from the dead, then you will be saved. And I believe that even watching this on a phone right now, that the Holy Spirit is speaking to you, that right now the presence of God is where you are, and he can save and change you right now. So if you need Jesus right now, you want that hope that enables you to look beyond what is going on, I want you to repeat this after me. Would you just pray this on your own and say, Jesus, today I receive your forgiveness. I receive your grace. Thank you for loving me. Thank you for dying for me. Thank you for making me right with God. And today, I believe that you have saved me and you have changed me. And right now, I receive your forgiveness. Come into my heart and I will follow you from this moment forward, as you show me how. In your precious name, amen. Can I tell you, friend, if you just prayed that prayer, Christ now lives on the inside of you. I would love to be able to connect with you from a distance, but connect with you, and then up close. Would you fill out that connection card? Just let us know. Say, hey man, I made this decision today. Hey, I'm choosing to follow Jesus. I'm starting fresh in my relationship with God. I would love to shoot you an email, give you a call, and really help you begin to take your next step in following Jesus. For everyone else, including those of you who prayed that prayer, can I tell you what our next step is in following Jesus? It's to go be the church. Let's go be Jesus. Because right now, there's a lot of people hurting. Right now, there's a lot of people struggling. And what they need is they need you and they need me to roll up our sleeves and say, church is not something that happens in a building. Church is where you are. And so we love you. I thank you for leaning in today. And know this, man, we love you so much. We're excited about all that God is doing in this season. And we truly believe that good is going to come out of this too. Amen.
What an incredible time we've had together. I pray that your faith has been encouraged, hope has been lifted, and that you know that you're so loved by God. Let's be the people who choose not to be blinded by what we're experiencing, but keep our eyes open to others God may want to use us to extend his love to. Now, we are the ones who get to let others know that he is good, he is for us, and he has not forgotten us, no matter what. Again, we love you, and we're here for you. If we can serve you in any way, do not hesitate to reach out. Now, you can find all of our contact info, details about the church, opportunities to serve in this unique season, and much more by clicking the Learn More button right now. Thank you for being a part of Believing Everywhere. And remember, believing is for you.